Welcome to Click My Project. Expressive, efficient, and revocable data access control for multi-authority cloud storage. The modified title is Ciphertext Policy, Attribute-Based Encryption, Attribute-Based Data Sharing with Attribute Revocation Method for Cloud Storage. Introduction. CBAPE is much more flexible than plain identity-based encryption in that it allows complex rules specifying which private keys can decrypt which ciphertext. Specifically, the private keys are associated with sets of attributes or labels, and when we encrypt to an access policy which specifies which keys will be able to decrypt. The CBAPE revocation method is efficient in the multi-authority cloud storage. Then it has a main two security processes. They are forward and backward security. Abstract. Ciphertext policy, attribute-based encryption. CBAPE is regarded as one of the most suitable technologies for data access control in cloud storage because it gives data owners more direct control and access policies. It is difficult to directly apply existing CBAPE schemes because of the attribute revocation problem. An attribute revocation method can efficiently achieve both forward security and backward security. The proposed revocable multi-authority CBAPE scheme as the underlying techniques to construct the expressive and secure data access control scheme for multi-authority cloud storage system. The data owner to initialize the system initialization and the data owner to store the data, and then the encryption data to be stored into the database, and then the another user to decrypt the data using the random key, and the data re-encryptions and re-decryptions also performed to the data owner, and the data to be stored in the cloud storage, and the revocable data access. Revocable data access means the data owner to view the content of the stored details. Now I am going to running the project Ciphertext Policy Attribute Based Encryption, Attribute Based Data Sharing with Attribute Revocation Method for Cloud Storage. This is a modified title for Expressive Efficient for Revocable Data Access for Cloud Storage. I am clicking the button and moving from next to frame. Here I am going to give the correct IP address. Here I am entered any wrong IP. I entered wrong IP, here username and the password. Here I am submitting the data, here invalid IP, then here the correct IP to be displayed. Then I am going to enter the correct IP, that means ATPL_CH_05-PC/192.168.2.10, and the username ANA and the password ANA. I'm clicking submit button, and next I'm clicking next. Here having personal details, medical summary, and checking process. I'm clicking personal details. Here I'm going to enter the patient's ID and the patient details in fever. Here I'm going to submit the button. Here random values to be displayed. Then I'm clicking next button. This is the revocation data. The revocation data to be displayed here. Here the revocation data to be displayed. And I'm clicking next. The medical summary. Here patient ID, patient name, and here I am going to browse the data. The data to be displayed, and here I am going to encrypt the data. Here the key to be displayed. And I am clicking submit button. Here the key to be displayed, and I'm clicking next button. Here I'm receiving the data. In the revocate the data, then I'm clicking next button. Here the secret key, and here I want to give the secret key 3120417512, and I'm decrypt the data. Here I'm clicking next button. It moves to the next frame. Here I'm going to get any one of the data from my system. Here I'm getting the length. Getting the length, free space, balancing size, total size, and record size. Then I'm clicking next button. It moves to next frame. Here I'm going to get any one of the data. Here I'm getting the file content. Then encrypt. Here I'm going to encrypt the data. Flowfish and DES. Then I'm clicking next button. Here I'm getting the input files. Then DES and EAS. That means encryptions to be applied. I'm clicking next button. Here I'm going to get the input files. Here Blowfish algorithms to be displayed. And I'm clicking next. Here I'm going to compressions and store. Again I'm going to run the server. That means I'm going to run the server storing. Here the data to be stored to the server. That means my system. That is on cloud storage processor. Here I'm going to run the processor. Here I'm going to receive then compressor. Here the data to be stored in my system, where the coding to be placed in zipped files, in compress. Here the data to be displayed. That means to store the data. Then here the performance evaluation. Here I'm having the graph, performance graph. In this graph, comparisons of cost, efficiency, and system. Proposed system and existing system comparisons. Here the graph to existing system and proposed system. That means effectiveness. Then graph 3, CPU processing and RAM processing, resource utilization. Thank you.